Now, if we want to build a use case diagram for our example, we have to add the use cases for these different actors. For instance, if we consider the student and the registrar, they might be both interacting with the maintain schedule system. The registrar, by updating the schedule, and the students by using the schedule that has been updated by the registrar. As you can see, different roles for the same use case. Another possible use case is the request course roster. In this case, the professor will request the roster by interacting with the system. We will continue in this way by further refining and by further adding use cases as we identify possible interactions of the actors that we identified with our system. So in summary, what the use case diagram is doing is to show the actors and their interaction with the system through a set of use cases. At this point, it should be pretty clear that, sure, this gives us an idea of the interactions, but we don't really know how these interactions occur. So there is one piece that is missing, which is how do we document the use cases? How do we describe what happens and what these interactions actually are? And that's exactly what we're going to discuss now, how to document use cases. So the behavior of a use case can be specified by describing its flow of events. And it is important to note that the flow of events should be described from an actor's point of view. So from the point of view of the external entity that is interacting with my system. So the description should detail what the system must provide to the actor when the use case is executed. In particular, it should describe how the use case starts and ends. It should describe the normal flow of events. What is the normal interaction? And in addition to the normal flow of events, it should also describe possibly alternative flows of events. For example, in the case in which there are multiple ways of accomplishing one action or performing a task. And finally, it should also describe exceptional flow of events. For example, assume that you're describing a use case for withdrawing money from an ATM. You might want to describe the normal flow of events, in which I insert my card, I provide my PIN, and so on. An alternative one, in which in addition to withdrawing cash, maybe I'll also first ask for some information about how much money is in my account. And finally, I may want to also describe an exceptional flow of events in which I get my PIN wrong, and therefore I'm not able to perform the operation. One more thing I want to mention when we talk about documenting use cases is the fact that the description of this information can be provided in two main ways: in an informal way or in a formal way. In the case of an informal description, we could just have a textual description of the flow of events in natural language. In the case of a formal or structured description, we might use, for example, pre- and post-conditions, pseudocode to indicate the steps. We could also use sequence diagrams, which is something that we will see in a minute.